Hello guys, now we shall learn how to draw a winding diagram in AutoCAD. So select AutoCAD by double clicking on it. So wait for a while, it will get open. Okay, once it get open, it looks like this. So before getting into the actual drawing, first we shall make necessary settings in the AutoCAD software. At the right bottom you can see that there is a workspace switching, so please left click it. So here you can see that AutoCAD Classic is ticked, so you tick drafting and annotation. So once you select drafting annotation, now screen becomes somewhat like this, and this is a screen which we want because this helps us to draw the winding diagram in easy manner. Okay, so then after this, then click anywhere on the screen and just press escape twice or thrice, and now type DS in sense draft settings DS. Okay, just click on it. So once you click on it, you can see that snap and grid, polar tracking, object snap. Okay, now we have made two lines here, one is the continuous one, the other one is dashed one. So close this. Now actually we should have done it earlier. No problem, we can do now also. Now again press escape twice thrice. Now press units, UNITS. Okay, it is appearing on the screen, just click it, units, and see that here it is given as in terms of inches, so make in terms of millimeters, then press okay. Guys, I have chosen a problem from your classwork, which a problem consists of 36 conductors and it's a double layer winding. So for 36 conductors double layer in sense, 18 are continuous and remaining 18 are discontinuous. So first we shall draw continuous lines, that is 18 number of lines, and later we shall draw 18 discontinuous lines. Press any cursor on the screen and press escape thrice. Type ortho, O-R-T-H-O, ortho, press enter and make sure it is turned on. If it is off, means turn on. Okay, it's off, turn it on. Now we can select a line here at the left top, here select it, and you can draw a line of any desired length on the page. Don't worry, will be always straight because ortho mode is turned on. So I have drawn a line. Okay, now we have to draw 18 more lines, like I said, because since number of conductors are 36, 18 are continuous and 18 are discontinuous. So first we shall draw a continuous line. You can see that when I select this, a three ticks are appearing on this line. So to draw such 18 conductors, so I have to go for an array command. So you can see here array, here's command is over here, then select array. You can see that how many number of rows we require, as only one row we require. So press one here and the rows option. And how many columns we require? Yes, it is 18 because 18 conductors are there. So once you press 18 and press enter, you'll get 18 such conductors. Okay, and again the distance between these two conductors, you can give around 1.5 or even you can give 2. Okay, 2 had given, fine. So 2 had given. Then what we'll do is, now we'll close the array. Okay, close the array. So 18 conductors I have drawn now. So 18 dotted conductors or dashed conductors are still required. So how to draw those dotted conductors? So for that, first what we will do is, we shall select the dashed conductor, as we have already prepared that layer earlier. Okay, so we know that somewhere in between we need to draw, but better draw always in between these conductors, and we will come to know how to find the center or middle position of this between these conductors. So for that, what we'll do is we shall draw a dotted line like this. We shall connect. Okay, then press escape, then press select. Okay, you can see that since we have opted for middle option from the draft settings, so a green arrow is indicating when you place your cursor over there at the middle point. So from there, left click and drag it to bottom. And again, we don't know what where exactly we have to stop. Do somewhat left and right here, so you'll get a cross mark here, and you press left key once more and then press escape. Okay, and again, we don't need this line anymore, so we shall select that line and we shall delete it. Okay, now it is deleted. Okay, similarly, like this, we shall draw 18 more conductors. And how we can do that? Again, by choosing an array command. So press 18, I mean press array, and again, how many rows? Like I said, 1, and how many? 18. Okay, and again, we have to choose length as 2. I mean the gap between two conductors is 2. Okay, so once you do that, you can see 18 conductors are continuous and 18 conductors are dotted. And you can move screen anywhere like this, from left or right, from top or bottom, by selecting this command, pan command here at the right. So select this and you can move free to move anywhere on the screen at your desired path. So once, and again, to come out of this command, just again press escape. That will be all done. Okay, 18 continuous and 18 discontinuous. Okay, now let us name these conductors by numbers. How to do that? By selecting test command. You can see that text command is over here. Select this. Okay, if after selecting this, you'll get single text as well as multi-line text. So choose single line text. Okay, so we know that always you have to begin from left to right. So I shall draw a small line like this of a minimal length. Are you able to see this? Draw a horizontal line like this after selecting this one and double click it. So after double clicking, you'll be able to see there is a highlighting. So press 1 over there and then press enter. Double enter. Okay, sometimes what happens, some of them will get this digit 1 as of different lengths and all. So for this, we have other option to reduce the length and all. You can type scale, that is SC scale. Okay, you can hold cursor anyway. You can see the length of the size of the one is getting change. Okay, depending upon your requirement, you can have the length or size of this digit. Okay, so after getting this, so please make sure you hold your place exactly after the before the conductor. Okay, as I like I said, pan command is there for you. I want a little bit closer, so I will turn off ortho now, as it is not allowing me to do so by pressing ortho command off. Now I will go there and I'm going to move it at any desired place. right? Okay, just before the connect. Okay, again to write 36, it's a time for using array command. So make sure before selecting array command to select one. See, one have selected, then press array. In how many rows? Like I said, one, because one row is there. In how many columns? Yes, it's not 18, it's now 36, because 36 conductors are there, right? I'm going to press 36. And again, what is the distance between two conductors? Yes, it's not two, it's one, right? So between the length, between the distance between two conductors, that is a dash as well as continuous, will be one. Okay, you can see that. What happened now? All 36 conductors are named with letter S. Now once you do that, you can close the array or press enter. Okay, you have pressed enter twice. You can see that digit 1 is named like this. Okay, but this is not the way. We have to change this from 1 to 36. So before doing that, first what to do is you select like this all the numbers, not even leaving a single number. Select like this. So after doing so, press X. You can see explode option is highlighting. Then press enter. Okay, so what explode means? Explode is dividing a single single into many, many things, into constant number of things. So you can see that all are divided. Before I was not giving option like this, now I'm getting option like this. What does it mean? It is divided into parts. So now after again selecting, already it is selected. Okay, if you want, you can select like this, select again. Now press T C O U N T, T count. Okay, once you press T count, press enter. You can see that X axis, Y axis selected or select order, since it is X axis. So let it be X axis itself. Okay, then press enter. It's asking overwrite. Yes, overwrite is required. Then press enter. Overwrite option should be highlighted like this. Okay, then click overwrite. You can see that these conductors are named with numbers from 1 to 36. Right, as you can see that it has overlapped on the lines and all. So for this, what we'll do is, again, we shall convert this into a single group by calling group, group. Okay, then press enter. Now you can see that again, these all conductors have acting like a single group. Okay, you can move anywhere at the desired. Okay, see how mode. Now it is no more overlapping. All conductors are named well with proper distancing. Yes, you can see that, right? No any overlapping is there. Fine. So now I have named all the conductors. See, since span command is selected, you can press escape to come out of this. Okay, by pressing escape twice or thrice. Okay, now as I told you, I have taken example from your classwork. So I have a winding table diagram here. I shall open it for you. You can see that first conductor is connected to eighth conductor. See, in this winding table, you worry about only the first serial number. One, that is one, that is one is connected to eighth conductor at the back side, and the front side it is connected from 8 to 3. Okay, backside means at the top, front means bottom. Okay, only you worry about these two, remaining things will be taken care by the software. Okay, one should be connected to 8 as well as 8 should be connected to 3. Okay, I will minimize this. One should be connected to 8 and 8 should be connected to 3, right? Yeah, 3. So how to do that? Again, I will take a line command here. Okay, I'll select here. I will go into connect